I now want to show you that the standard algorithm for multiplying numbers can also be used. It's not just limited to base 10. It can also be used, frankly, it can be used in any base, but we're going to do it in base 2. And base 2 is especially fun because you essentially have to only know your multiplication tables through 1. So you just have to know that 0 times 0 is 0, 1 times 0 is 0, and that 1 times 1 is 1. And then you're ready to go. You're ready to multiply in base 2. So let's do that. So let's say we have, let's say we take 9. So let's see, 9 is going to be 1, 8, 0, 4s, 0, 2s, and 1. So this is 9 right over here, represented in base 2. And let's say we were to multiply that times, let's say we were to multiply that times 7. So we should obviously, if we know our multiplication tables, we should get 63. So 7 is 1. Actually, I'm going to put a 0 in. 7 would be 1, 1, 1, but that's a little bit boring. So let's instead do 9 times 5, which we know should be 45. So this is 1, 4, no 2s, and 1, 1. So 4 plus 1 is going to be 5. So this is 9 times 5, and we're doing it in base 2. So once again, same algorithm. And actually, before I do it, I encourage you just pause the video and try to use the same algorithm that you've used for base 10 multiplication. Use the same algorithm here, and let's see if we actually do get that 9 times 5 is 45. So I'm assuming you've had a go at it. Let's work through it together. So let's start right over here in the ones place. So we multiply 1 times 1 is 1, 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 1 is 1. Then we can go to the 2's place. And since we're multiplying all of this times the 2's place, we can throw a 0 right over here. But of course, 0 times each of these is just going to be a bunch of zeros. So we, 0 times 1 is 0, 0 times 0 is 0, 0 times 0 is 0, 0 times 1 is 0. So I really didn't have to write that, but I'm just doing it so that you see that I'm using the standard algorithm. And then we go to the 4's place. And since we're in the 4's place, let's put some zeros here. So 0, 0. We're essentially figuring out, we're essentially talking about a certain number of 4s, not a certain number of 1s. So 1 times that is just going to be 1, 0, 0, 1. And now we're ready to add. Now we are ready to add. So 1 plus a bunch of zeros is 1. A bunch of zeros, that's going to be 1. 1 plus a bunch of zeros is 1, zeros, and 1. And we're done. And obviously, if we had more than 1, 1 in any of these places right over here, then we might have had to carry a 1. But we saw that when we added numbers in binary. But let's actually verify that this is the number that we would expect it to be. Remember, this right over here is the ones place. So let's see, this is ones, fours. Let me write it down. This is ones, twos, 4s, 8s, 16s, and 32s. So we have 132, so it's going to be 32, plus 1, 8. And once again, we only have to do this for ourselves because we're so used to thinking in base 10. If you were thinking in base 2, you'd say, oh, I know what this number is, and you would have some name for it, probably different than 45, because 45, the name essentially is kind of a base 10 name, and we'd probably have better names in terms of base 2. Someone actually should do that. That would be a fun project. So let's see, we have 32 plus 8 plus 4. Plus 4, plus 1, which is indeed equal to 45.